Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. It is Election Day. Many of the big races are expected to be very close. Candidates were out this morning marking their ballots. In the U.S. Senate race, incumbent Senator Jean Shaheen voted in her hometown of Madbury. Republican challenger Scott Brown voted in his hometown of Rye. This has been one of the most closely watched races in the entire country. In the race for governor, incumbent Governor Maggie Hassan was out in Exeter early this morning. Republican challenger Walt Havenstein voted in Alton. And our latest WMUR Grand Estate poll shows that this race has also tightened. Ray Brewer was also out there and spoke with voters today.
Good morning.
6 o'clock in the morning, and the voters were ready. Lines formed early at Ward 1 in Manchester, people wanting to cast their ballots before heading off to work. It was issues bringing some people out, civic duty for others.
Well, I think the women's right and the pay that women receive. School issues, the funding, as far as student loans.
The Secretary of State is predicting nearly 54% of registered voters will cast ballots in this election. Pelham moderator Phil Currier says by mid-morning, about 700 out of nearly 9,000 registered voters had cast their ballots. Most polls show the economy and the feeling that the country is heading in the wrong direction are the top issues on voters' minds. That was true for these two voters in Pelham.
Jobs. People need to get working. And we need to get people off of welfare and into jobs.
I think state economy, also the direction of our country. I mean, it's a turning point.
In Derry, voter turnout at the Gilbert Hood Middle School was light. The moderator says they'll be hard-pressed to reach the predicted turnout. Here, the economy also seemed to be a major concern.
And I think that people have to rein in, you know, our overspending and stuff like that.
And remember, you can find all the polling hours here on our website. We have all the campaigns covered as the returns come in tonight. Our primetime television coverage begins at 9 p.m. on WMUR and online on MeTV. You can also find the latest results here on our website, WMUR.com. A Somersworth woman is being treated for serious burns right now after an accident involving an oxygen tank. Firefighters were called to a home on Main Street early this morning. They say the 67-year-old victim lit a cigarette while using oxygen. No word on her current condition. A bizarre accident in Keene. Police say a person driving a minivan was trying to avoid something in the road and ended up crashing into that house. This was the scene on West Street Monday night. Police say no one was hurt and the home was considered safe to stay in. Nashua police say they've broken up a major retail crime ring that had been stealing and selling tens of thousands of dollars worth of merchandise. Authorities arrested these six people, now charged with selling hundreds of stolen items to two pawn shops in Nashua. Police also charged the owners of Family Pawn and Nashua Pawn. They're due in court today. Be sure to tune in at 5 o'clock when we begin our live team coverage with all the statewide candidates. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everyone.